improv cavalcade. Who's ready for improv? We got a packed house tonight. We got some lovely groups performing tonight. The High Fivers are here. Also, Thanksgiving 2007 is here. A member of the Penthouse Basements. Bookmarking the evening, also bookending and bookmarking Sherwood. Okay, the Penthouse Basements will be performing right now. We're going to start with a game called Questions Only. This is for myself, Oliver, Rachel, and Dave. Okay, we're going to do a scene for you, but we can only speak in questions. So what do we need from the audience? A place where there will be a sense of urgency.
Bathroom!
Airport.
Dunkin' Donuts.
Donuts on Free Donut Day. Okay, questions only. Jeremy, you are the arbiter of this.
Yes!
If nobody speaks, if somebody doesn't speak in a question or we take too long, fumble our words, like I just did, we go away and the next person replaces us. Okay, questions only at a Dunkin' Donuts on Free Donut Day. Go.
Hey, you got a blueberry cake?
Did you read the ad?
Does it say 2 for $1? Could you hurry up, please? I gotta get to Wrigley Field.
You're done, Allie.
What's going on?
Haven't you heard?
What is it?
Didn't you know we're changing management?
Bill's not here anymore?
Bill's dead!
You going to Bill's funeral?
I don't know. Why, Bill, why?
What killed him?
Didn't you see him eat bacon every morning, noon, and night?
Wasn't he Jewish?
Why do you think God struck him down? Are you a mad Jew too?
What does the Bible say?
I don't know.
Have any bear claws?
Which ones are those?
Those.
How much for some Krispy Kremes under the table?
Oh, you're done.
Did someone ask for their Krispy Kremes under the table?
Are you Big Lou?
Did you see me in 1982 in Big Lou's Big Krispy Kreme under the table?
Can you prove it's you?
Will you know when it hits you?
When is it gonna hurt?
Have you ever been hit by a donut before?
Once.
Any milk?
I think I saw some in the back, didn't I?
See? That was lovely. I hope that we finally captured the scene inside of a Dunkin' Donuts. No free donuts. This is not a Dunkin' Donuts. I don't want to confuse anyone. Okay, next game. It's called Who's Line, and this is for Dave and Jeremy. So now, these two lovely lads are going to do a scene for you, but during that scene, they must interject these random lines written by members of our studio audience. They don't know what they are. They could be anything.
Hoo-ha! You've made a terrible mess.
Soon it will be cleaned up by you improvisers. Okay, what I need from the audience now is, what did you want to be when you grew up?
A dog.
Steve Irwin.
Too soon?
It's always too soon.
His daughter's like in college now.
A corn dog maker.
Come on, hit me with some more.
A train, a firefighter,
astronaut.
Peace to the gods, and peace to me. I think I'll live forever and never die.
I don't care about the gods, Chuck. I just want to see your handsome face one more time. I don't want to have to look at our daughter, Juliet, and say to her, do the right thing. How is she going to know what the right thing is when her father's gone?
Don't worry. I'll be back. I'll be covered in medals. I think Eisenhower himself is going to help me out. He'll look me in the eye. He'll say, right to my face, snap. Yes, gasp you should, for that is clearly the highest honor that a general can give.
The snap, the crackle, and the pop.
The train's almost here. It's calling time. I have to leave soon, my name. I have to go. I have to.
More saving. More doing. Home Depot. We need to save and do more, don't you understand?
Who told you about Operation Home Depot?
I think it was Mexican.
Sanchez! Knew he was a spy! Alright, honey, this is serious. Okay, you can't go home right now. If Sanchez is in on Operation Home Depot, you have to get on the train now, okay?
I'm in danger?
Yes, from Sanchez.
I have to go to the front? The only thing holding her together are the bird droppings!
The train will still make it there, okay? It doesn't matter.
Are you sure? Maybe some malts and nuts would be good.
Those are kind of in there too. All right. I think that's important, okay? Sanchez could be here any moment, alright? Alright, now listen carefully. Listen very carefully. You don't have to go home, but you can stay here. It's a secret. It's a secret.
See
you.
Third Eye Blind fan, right there? Next game, Schoolyard Bully. Yes, Schoolyard Bully is the next game. Okay. This is for everyone but me. Jeremy and Rachel shall go upstairs so they cannot hear what we're going to do here. Bye bye!
Go see Jeremy!
Alright, he's gone. Okay. This game, Rachel and Jeremy will be schoolyard adversaries. And they're going to be taunting each other with a very specific taunt. What is it? Adjective, noun? And they don't know what it is. These two groups of improvisers will be acting out the adjective, noun, and they have to guess it. And the first person who gets it wins a new Cadillac. Okay, so let me get an adjective.
Moist.
Spiky.
Spiky's good. Get another adjective.
Moist. Ground beef.
Do you say ground beef?
We can use that for our noun.
Fire.
Grumpy.
Urine stain.
Grumpy. Okay, urine stain, I heard. Right, yeah. Okay, so first one was spiky urine stained ground beef. Because I heard, didn't somebody say that?
I said that.
Okay, I need a noun.
Ground beef,
I think I heard. Okay, spiky urine stained ground beef. Let me get
our two people. I encourage you to drink before we have to act these out.
No, I'm telling!
No, you won't.
Yeah.
I'm going down. Right here, in this bar basement.
What? Can't believe you dragged me down here.
They're mistaken for being a bar next to a school.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell your mom you're in a bar.
You wouldn't dare.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. Cause you know why? Cause you are just a conehead. You are just a spiky.
Spiky. Yeah. Spiky.
Oh, you get a haircut.
Spiky. You know what you are? Well, you know. You are a fire hose. You know. Alpita is with a fire hose.
You would not, I can't believe you said that. I am not a fire hoser, right? Now sometimes just point at the junk, jump. That's you. You're a shooty junk. You're rubbing it out. You know how it is, you have spiky, sauteed, dirty stink. You're a stink, you're a dirty, spiky stink, stainy. You're a stinky penis.
Peck their way out is the winner. But The audience gives us a fluid that is flooding the cup. And we have to fight our way through the fluid and get through the fluid out of the Dixie cup.
All right. And Zazie, what is your version of Be My Rhapsody?
Well, I didn't go to Juilliard, but on the block we played Be My Dixie Chicken. It was at Del Close that we used to play. Which actually has to do with folks come around, Southerners, and want to talk and make friends with a new person who's a Yankee, right? And the Yankee tries as hard as he can to have a Southern accent, but fails. And every time he does it, or she gets the Southern accent wrong with whatever ridiculous accent they try, the other group gets to kick him in the shin.
Okay, bringing the North and the South together in the Dixie Chicken. And Rachel,
yeah.
What is your version of Be My Dixie Chicken?
All right, it's a lot like Please Don't Stay, Please Go, no, Please Stay, Don't Go, whatever. So, it's called Be My Dixie Chicken. So one of them is very, you know, one of them wants you to be there, so you go, oh, be mine, and the other one is really chicken, so they're always trying to get away. That's it.
I liked it. Okay, so now, unlike the U.S. electoral process, the winner with the most popular vote is going to be declared the winner and will play their game.
Oh, well, I already brought this zone.
But we have to review, so everyone can remember. Let's see if I can remember. We had,
I don't remember mine.
We had David's game, where it's a bunch of chickens inside of a Dixie cup. Yeah. But wait, the audience supplies a fluid that's drowning the Dixie cup, and you have to escape from.
They suggest the fluid, they don't supply it.
Supply as an important suggestion, or...
That's for later after the show.
And now we have Zazie's game, where it's a northerner and a southerner, and a northerner, two southerners, and that's all I remember. What was the rest?
So, the northerner is trying to fit in with the two southerners, who just call him chicken and other random names as he tries and tries again, and fails at his attempts at southerners.
Attempting a silly leech. And Rachel's, I forgot yours too. What was your show?
One of them is in love and the other is a chicken. Like a scared chicken, not like an actual animal chicken.
Oh, okay.
There's two scared, and so, yeah, so one keeps trying to get away and the other keeps trying to draw out.
That's adorable. Okay, now it's time to vote. Who wants David's game with Dixie Cups and Fluids? Who wants Zazie's game with the North and the South? Rachel's game with love and being a chicken. Yay! I think David gets it.
Why do you hate northerners?
They don't like sweet tea.
They're rude.
We got it.
They don't say excuse me.
How do you declare it is hot as a southern peach in July?
Well, sweet baby, it is a good thing that all we got is this sweet southern ass tea. Choking on something, like?
No! I am completely at home here. Well, aren't you special?
I do declare! Why do you look like a chicken with no feathers?
She does. She looks like a chicken that's got plum all the feathers plucked off.
My dear, have you ever been to the Bojangles? South staple, my dear.
You know you pick a good town when those KFCs turn into Bojangles.
My dear, do you even have a General Lee tattoo on your arm?
Well, I am certainly aware of what the thing is. I need to get buttered. Huh, show me your butter of life. See where the pole is?
Unexpected turn. Next game, show-stopping number. Now, this is for Broadway fans. This is for your, Jeremy and I and Dave will be the showstopper. So what happens? Jeremy and I will be doing a normal scene, and during that scene, Dave will stop us after a line, and whatever that line is, the person has to come up with a brassy, sassy, and bold show-stopping number. So what I need from the audience is a Broadway musical that has not been made.
Pulling Your Wagon.
Pulling Your Wagon, that's a good one. Okay, show-stopping number, Pulling Your Wagon.
Why so glum, Jeff?
I got let go from the farm.
Freeze! I got let go from the farm!
I got let go from the farm, and there is a lot of harm because my wagon is empty and I'm not happy! Look at this, it's empty, there's no turnip feet or hay! What am I gonna do? Oh my god, I don't know what to say, I gotta find a new job! Find a new job! If I don't, I might have to rob!
No!
Not yet! I got old 60 here just in case! Look! It's empty.
How would you like to fill up that wagon?
Freeze! Fill up that wagon!
Ba-da-ba-da-ba-ba. My friend, I got a question for you.
What?
Not two, but one. This is the question that I'm gonna say. You and me, we're gonna do a passion play.
To do the Passion of the Christ to find it?
That was purely for rhyming!
Oh, oh, thank God! Oh, I don't think it's all this. It's not good if a Jewish guy does it.
It's from the Bible. Freeze! It's not good if a Jewish guy does
it! It's not good if a Jewish guy does the Passion of that guy that died. We would all be sad and then watch you and I. Because we're gonna find the treasure, no matter what it takes.
Oh, yeah.
Go, find the treasure. Find the treasure and the gold, because we know that you and I can be so bold. So let us find that treasure.
I heard talk, the old mine, that's where the treasure is. We got old 60 loaded.
And the old wagon I'll pull.
Unload it so we can fill it with gold.
No, the wagon, unload it. The gun, load it.
Freeze! The wagon unloaded, the gun loaded, double song!
Ba 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 ba.
Let me tell you what I'm gonna do. It's gonna be great. We'll go through the mine. We'll get lots of money. It won't be sad. We're gonna be real funny.
That's great because I'm ready. I've got my accent key.
Yeah!
It unlocks the door.
and I'll hit that guard in the knee.
Oh, yeah!
We'll dig down deep, right to the gold. Then we'll grab it, and to the treasury, it will be sold.
Woo!
Yeah! All right, okay, we're gonna bust in. You know the guns are blazing. I'll just stun. Gold's not that heavy, is it?
Pretty sure it's lighter than air.
Okay, I'm just gonna start stuffing it in my pants, and then I'll put it in the wagon, and then we'll pull it away.
Okay, but who will take the wagon?
Freeze! Who will take the wagon? Duet spoken at the exact same time!
less time. Psych! 3 seconds! Go!
Four! In the back!
Go!
Yes!
No! See! We're really done. We can't go any less than 3 seconds.
Yeah, we will.
Then we're gonna do 1 second! Ready? Go! That's great. That was amazing. Okay, final game of the Penthouse Basements. We're gonna do a traditional Irish drinking song for you guys. Okay, this is for myself, Pete, Dave, and Jeremy. What will happen now? Zazie, okay, yes, all right. What we need from the audience is something, a major life event.
Pregnant, birth.
Wedding.
Birth, okay, the Irish drinking song about birth. It will be really fun.
It could be a boy.
In the oven is the bun.
Oh, it's getting bigger.
Very, very large.
I think I'll have natural childbirth.
Or I'm in charge.
So I've got to be bad, so packed now.
I am quite prepared.
I'm going to have a baby.
But I'm getting de-hairs.
Calling out now.
What should I?
Just shave my cat.
The baby is turning blue!
Oh, the daisies is so blue now.
It might die.
Time to come out, baby!
I guess it's not a guy.
I hope I have insurance.
I hope my medical bills are low.
I hope there is a doctor.
If there is, I'll give him a blow.
But it hurts a lot!
I'll need some painkillers.
Oh my god, just give me a shot!
I wonder who the dad is.
I wonder if he's a duck.
He could be really cool.
Or a stupid fuck!
Okay, whenever you have an idea, just go up to the chair and touch it and say your joke and everybody will laugh. Okay, we're gonna do, I once dated, give me an inanimate object.
Lamp.
I once dated a lamp.
I once dated a lamp, but I could never turn around.
I once dated a lamp, she wasn't very bright. I once dated a lamp, I could turn her on with the clap.
I once dated a lamp, but she was only 49 shades.
I once dated a lamp, but she was pretty shady.
I once dated a lamp. I loved her.
I once dated a lamp. She always wanted an LED.
I once dated a lamp. She had a nice big pair of bows.
Once dated a lamp, you could always buy my switch.
I once dated a lamp, she helped me leave green.
I once dated a lamp, I rubbed him, but I didn't get any wishes.
I once dated a lamp, but she wouldn't pull my cord.
I once dated a lamp, and later on, I found out she was three-pronged.
I once dated a lamp that was too old and oily.
I was there, lamp. Her name was IKEA.
I once dated a lamp. She filled me with lots of lava.
I once dated a lamp and I wanted a ladder.
plumber. Clown.
Plumber! 99 plumbers walk into the bar.
Bartender says, we don't serve plumbers here, so the plumbers cracked him over the head.
The bartender says, we don't serve your kind here. If you thought you'd ever get in here, that'd be a pipe dream.
99 plumbers walk into a bar and say, let the liquids flow.
99 plumbers walk into a bar, and says, we don't serve plumbers here. And the plumbers say, well, we got $195 just for showing up.
99 plumbers walk into a bar, and the bartender says, that's a lot of plumbers in one place.
99 plumbers walk into a bar, and he says, we don't serve plumbers here, and he wrenched the drink from their hand.
Famous action hero. He likes to say a lot of quips. We will be doing a game where he will be giving a quip at the death of a victim. Give us a place where you ran an errand today.
The guy now.
Post office. If Arnold Schwarzenegger killed you at a post office.
This stamp is not forever!
I was going to kill you, but now it's time for my smoke break.
Your hours are very short!
Hey, Fed. You, P.S. Fed your ass!
Nor rain, nor sleep, nor blank!
You did not deliver!
Yes, I will fill you with 2-3 ounces of life!
I like my women.
Yes, I like my women like I like my...
Or men.
We don't discriminate here.
An object. We need an object.
Yes.
Crowns.
What do you say?
Crowns.
Crowns.
Crowns?
Like crayons in a weird accent or crowns in a weird accent?
It's art supplies, which includes crayons.
I like my women. I like my art supplies. They're very easel.
I like my women like I like my paint. Thinner.
I like my men like I like my paint. Bare.
Down my throat. All right, that's it. All right, I want to thank a high five, guys.
stand-up comedy at 9 o'clock, so...